And ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Midland Community Stadium for today's MHSAA District Championship game. It's the Dow High Chargers and the Midland High Chemics. And this is Dave Marsh bringing you the action along with Frank Aldemore and Coach. Second time the two rivals have played in the playoffs in this long storied history.
This is going to be an excellent game tonight. I do not believe it will be the same as what we had 2 weeks ago. I believe Dow has learned its lesson. Dow, last 2 weeks ago, looked like deer got hit in the headlights, and Midland just came out and pounded Dow. All right, we're going to come up with some keys to the game now as we... All right, we're going to keep on going. Here's our first keys to the game. This is Midland, and obviously it's more of the same. Don't change. If it's not broke, don't try to fix something that's not broke. And this is they're going to run the football. They're going to give the ball to Will Williams for 30 times, and they are going to do some controlled passing. They need to create some turnovers, and that is the key issue with Midland all year long on their defense, and their defense has been playing great in the last couple weeks. And for Midland, it is always going to be a field possession game. So now let's go to Dow, and they got to be more physical. 2 weeks ago, they did not do the job on defense, and obviously not the job on offense. They have to contain Will Williams. He cannot gain 300 yards or 250 yards or 200 yards. I would say if they can hold Will Williams under 150, it's good. And third, Dow must take what they give you. Midland, 2 weeks ago, just defied them to run the football, and Dow didn't listen to them. They just kept throwing it. So now we're ready to get going. We have the national anthem coming up soon, and this is going to be a great football game.
Well, you mentioned Midland won that city title game 2 weeks ago, 45-6, pretty much having their way in all facets of the game. But Dow High bounced right back last week in their playoff opener. They defeated Fenton 30-21 and had an outstanding game. In particular, quarterback Brennan Miller was phenomenal, throwing for 250 yards, and he ran for 112 and two touchdowns. So Miller had a tremendous outing, and they're going to need him to repeat that performance here tonight. Midland, meanwhile, 9-1 on the year, ranked number 9 in the state in Division II. They won their first-round matchup over Marquette 41-10, and, Coach, that was almost a carbon copy of the Dow game. Midland
exactly.
Just ran. Will Williams with 267 yards against Dow, 268 against Marquette.
Two things that come into play in last week's game. In the third quarter, Dow High took the football and kept it for almost 7 minutes, which did not allow Fenton's high-power offense to do something. The second thing was it was 17-10 at halftime in the Midland-Marquette game. In the third quarter and early in the fourth quarter, Marquette turned the ball over 3 times inside their 20-yard line for 21 points, and that's the ball game. So it's this creation of turnovers, and in Dow's case, they got physical last week with Fenton, and that became a key issue.
Well, yeah, Dow looking to match that performance here tonight, and the crowd here is on its feet as we will be having the national anthem from the Midland High Meister Singers and the Dow High Choir right down on the field. So we will send it on down for tonight's national anthem.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time we ask that you stand. The privilege of this game was made possible by those who have fought and continue to fight for the freedoms we enjoy. Let us honor and respect their efforts and our country by, gentlemen, removing your hats. Veterans and service members not in uniform may render the military salute. Everyone standing at attention with your hands over your hearts as we proudly join in with the Midland High Meister Singers and the Dow High Choir in singing our national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so
By the Meister Singers from Midland High and the Dow High Choir with tonight's national anthem as we get ready for the district championship game, Midland versus Dow. You mentioned the second time these two teams have met in the postseason. It was back in 2005. Midland won in the first round of the playoffs 20-9. And this is the first time that they'll be playing for the district title between these two teams. And the winner will go on to play the winner of Lowell and Muskegon, who they are playing tonight, I believe. And the winner of this game will travel to one of those two teams next week.
Or Lowell.
Or Lowell, one of the two teams. So big ball game coming up here. Dow High won the toss, so they defer to the second half. Midland will receive the opening kickoff here in a few minutes. And we had mentioned Will Williams has 1,593 yards on the ground this season, 24 touchdowns, but over 500 of that has come the last two games.
Exactly. He's really, well, first off, they're giving him the ball more. I mean, they're giving it to him 33 times, which I've always said that's exactly when you've got a hot shooter, just turn him loose. And he's going to be turned loose tonight again. Because I believe Midland believes that they can beat Dow up physically. And that's what they're going to do. They're going to get back into that, sometimes that three-back offense, sometimes that two-tight-end type offense that they've used at different times and have been very successful with it. Dow is beat up. And not to make any excuses for Dow, because they've been beat up all year and have been quite resilient. But they are missing some very, very key players. Chase McNamara was lost in the middle of the Midland game. He's an excellent outside linebacker, offensive lineman. Nate Thurston, who's was a top lineman, linebacker at 6'3", was an excellent player. He tore an ACL last week. And Chase Quincer, a 6'4", 220, again, offensive lineman, defensive lineman. He's out with a dislocated kneecap. Now, those are some crucial issues, because those are big guys that are replaced by little guys.
Right.
And you know, you just got to have big guys to take on power. And not only were they big guys, they were pretty good players. So but that's not, you know, injuries are a part of the game. Injuries happen. Midland has been blessed. They are relatively injury-free. And as the year goes on, you just hope that nothing happens to the players that really have to produce big. A Will Williams type of player.
Right. And Williams, number five for the Chemics, is back deep to receive, along with number one, Jakari Cooper. Cooper is a sophomore. And we are about to get underway here. Max Kidd doing the kicking duties for the Chargers. We are underway in this postseason game. The ball is loose. And it's free,
and I
think Dow got it. Yes, they did. So Midland is noted for making big special teams plays, and just like that, Dow reverses that and comes up with that huge play. It was kind of a typical Midland-type kick, a short, almost a pooch kind of a kick, and it hit the turf, and once it does that, it's anybody's ball. And the Chargers come up with the first big play of the game.
And again, a lost possession and a turnover. Those are crucial things in games like this. Ball inside the 20-yard line, what's going to happen?
On the 18, Dow takes over to start things off. Senior Brendan Miller, the quarterback, pitches to Caleb Richard. He finds a hole, bounces to the outside, and rambles on down. The ball is loose. And Midland takes over. He cut it back. The ball came loose. It was a mad scramble for the ball. And finally, the Chemics corral it down at about the 3-yard line. Oh, man.
Terrific play here.
Good cutback.
Cutback. Great strip of the ball. It comes out. Everybody's after it. It's still loose. And the Midland guys did a great job of blocking out the Dow guys to get the football.
Good job of sliding and staying in bounds on the recovery. Couldn't quite see who made the play for the Chemics, but wow, just like that, Dow turns it back over to Midland.
Boy, there is one giant lost opportunity for Dow.
And Midland will start off with that powerhouse backfield. Williams with the first carry. He cuts up. He's got room. He's on his feet to the 40. He reaches midfield, finally hauled down. But not after a monster play all the way into Dow territory to the 44-yard line. Oh, my goodness. Skyler Cattardi finally with the tackle.
A great cutback. Dow did a good job of closing things off. I got through into the secondary, and once he got into the secondary, now Cantari is just going to run him down, which is an outstanding job by Cantari just to keep the game alive. And this really just completely changed field position for the Chemics.
Three plays in this game, all huge plays so far. And again, that power backfield. It's Williams again, this off the left side. He's stuffed this time. It's Jacob Loria on the tackle. Good play by Loria. That offensive line for Midland has just been fantastic here down the stretch this season. On that right side, right tackle is Zach Stern, number 54. He's the right tackle. He's a first-team All-Saginaw Valley League North player. Matt Schnurr, 68, on the right at the right guard position. Austin Rapanis, the center. He's also an all-conference player. And on the left side is Nate Fisher and Jacob Dostal. Williams again off the left side. Turns ahead. There's a flag on the play. It's probably going to be a hold. The umpire threw the flag, and that's almost always holding. But we will see here. Yeah, that's a hold on Midland High. So the big second down pickup is going to be marched back.
Well, 10 yards. The difference here, and take away that first play, but the difference is Dow is staying as low as it can be, almost in Midland grub style football. And Williams is quick enough to find that little seam. And if Dow stays good and low and can clog up some space, there's an example of what happens. You're going to hold because you've got a person underneath you. The moment your arms come out away from the framework of the body, that's a hold.
And Midland is flagged for that. The Midland looks like they're going to go back to that power backfield. That's when they put 21 Michael Alexander and number 10 Jordan Wilson. They're linebackers normally, but they've been using them a lot here in the double fullback position. And they do again. Williams, left side. It's going to pick up about 5 on the play. It'll be a third and long, about 14 for the Chemics.
See, both of these teams are making a point. Who is going to control the line of scrimmage? Who wins the line of scrimmage? Well, at this point right here, it's early. But right now, Dow is controlling the line of scrimmage. Take away that first run. That first run, Williams broke it way back. And you know, and when you're running that play, the running back needs to have a feel for the hole. Williams has a feel for the hole.
Right. Number 11, Austin Ear. Top receiver up wide to the right here. Wilson in the slot. And Midland's going to call timeout here with 9:50 remaining. And lot of action here
already
in the early going.
The key to this game is right here, the conversion of third downs. Here is a stat that I found hard to believe, and I had to go back and watch the ball game again to make sure of it, but Dow did not convert a third down in the entire game 2 weeks ago.
Wow.
They did not convert a single third down. Midland here is third and 12, third and 14, and this is a big first down for them. They have to at least get it up there to where fourth down is a maybe. And if they don't make it on fourth down, then they have another turnover. That's a turn. If you don't make a fourth down conversion, that's a turnover. So we're looking at turnovers. Both of them have one. Both of them have zero on their possessions. So, as I said, it's a matter of possessions, because in the first game, Midland had nine possessions and scored on seven of them.
Here we go. Gross. Back to pass. He's going deep, and he's dropped. Oh, boy. Luke DeLong. Perfect pass thrown by Tanner Gross, and I think he was thinking end zone before
he
hauled that in.
That was a perfect pass, and
And that was, if not a touchdown, was going to put it inside the 10, but Midland will be forced to punt here. Will Williams is the punter for the Chemics. And Mason Hayes back deep for the Chargers. A line drive punt. Hayes will field it at the 13. He's got a little hole. And a good hard run back. A late flag on the play. It was behind the play. And so we'll see what the call is here. Hayes returned it out to the 29-yard line. And it's going to be a hold on Dow.
So this could be a big penalty, because holding is a spot foul, and so it's going to take it back.
The flag's on the 21.
That's a 10-yard from that spot, so that puts it back on the 11 and ends up being about a 25-yard penalty.
Right, yeah. So it's being marched all the way back to the 10-yard line. So, yeah. Big penalty here, and second possession for Dow. You mentioned, you saw they fumbled on their first play of the game. Much longer field to go here behind Brennan Miller, first team all-conference quarterback. Miller pitches to Richard, and he is brought down. Michael Alexander on the tackle. Number 21, Michael Alexander, you're going to hear his name a lot. He is a wrecking ball defensively.
Dow is still convinced that it can run the perimeter on Midland, and it just isn't there. I mean, they ran a toss play, and they run a wide option, and those plays are not there. What is there is inside. There is one man standing up, or one man down, 10 men standing up, and nobody from center to
little bubble screen. Oh, great quick play by Dow.
Michael Alexander, tremendous play right there. That was a lot of yards taken away by Michael Alexander. What a great read.
Travis McNally on the reception for Dow High. He'll bring up a third and 7. Mentioned Miller, 2,156 yards passing on the year, 21 touchdowns, only 4 interceptions. Incredible senior season for Miller. Back to pass. He's looking down the middle of the field. He's got his man. It's going to be a first down. Complete to Justin Cook.
Excellent pass right in the seam. This is a seam route. Midland zone is sitting back there. It gets right in between, over the linebackers and in front of the safeties, and they convert a first down. That's a big play.
Justin Cook, the sophomore, on the reception out to the 35. Miller threw that ball with authority. A lot of confidence in that play right there. It's good to see. Charger fans will be glad to see that. Caleb Richard tripped up, but not after about a 5-yard gain. Paul pops loose, but I'm pretty sure he was down. Richard, the ball
carrier. Okay, that's two fumbles for Richard. Somebody needs to tell him to put the 5 points on the ball.
Yeah.
You got to hold it at five different points on the ball. And right now that ball has to be laying out there a little bit away from his body.
Second and four, Caleb Richard.
And I really believe, Dave, that Caleb Richard is the key to Dow's offense. He needs to touch the ball more than the 13 times he did last week.
Should be a flag on the play. It was. He's receiver in the slot, jumped a little bit early. Caleb Richard, he's a junior, has over 700 yards rushing and over 700 yards receiving, 20 touchdowns on the year, so he is a major part of this offense. You can also look for Mike Robb, another sophomore receiver. He's gained over 600 yards receiving on the year and six touchdowns. So Dow with a lot of weapons. They are the number one offensive team in the Saginaw Valley League North. Miller's keeping it this time, and he's hauled down. Got it out to about the 40.
So this is their first third down conversion attempt.
Matt McInerney, number 46, and Andy Russell, number 2, in on the stop for Midland. At defensive front, Ben Luzar, Colin Coltson, Tanner Diamond, Azariah Porter for Midland. Here we go, third and five. Miller back to pass. He finds Cook again, and that's going to be another first down. So Cook came out just kind of curled beyond the sticks. Miller found him, and Dow High's moving down the field.
That was right at the stick. That's an excellent stick route. He got to the first down, turned around, settled down. Good pass by Miller. Very good. Dow's playing much better, much more physical.
A lot more assertiveness and confidence. Caleb Richard on the carry. Stays on his feet. Bounces it outside, and a nice pickup on first down. Russell on the tackle. But good pickup on first down into Midland High territory.
See, now field position has just now changed again, because even if Dow is not successful in this route, then they're going to kick right. The ball. Their kicker's good enough to pin Midland back in the hole again. And that's what you want to do. You want to pin your opponent inside the 15-yard line every time.
Cook comes in motion to the left. Handoff. McNally is close to the first down. Depends on the spot. It looks like they're going to give it to him. So Dow High offensive line doing a much better job here. That starting offensive line, Jacob Loria, number 54. Bradley Drinkpool, number 63, he's a sophomore, called up from JV's for this game to replace the injured player. 59, Wes Meyer. Number 70, Austin Wilford, who's a junior, and another junior, number 77, Brandon Veal. And they will indeed move the sticks. Ball on the Midland High 42-yard line.
See, the difference so far in this first quarter has been they've decided that Caleb Richard is an integral part of this offense. And when he is, then they are successful. That's going to free Miller up.
A swing pass to Richard, tripped up. Good defensive play there. Cody Snyder, number 8 for Midland High. And that's going to be a loss of yardage.
Those wideouts have to block on that play. And that was a very, very good defensive play by the Midland corner.
Absolutely, because there was a lot of green in front of Richard had Snyder not made the tackle. So the linebacker core for Midland, McInerney, 46. We mentioned Alexander and Wilson. And then in the secondary, number 3, Luke DeLong, number 2, Andy Russell, number 9, Brad Belson is a corner, and Cody Snyder also at cornerback. Miller's got his, he drops it. Mike Robb, he had him kind of the same play to the right side as he just ran to the left side, and that had a lot of potential too. Robb, I think, slightly took his eye off it, trying to pick up the yardage before he corralled the ball. It'll bring up a third and a long 11 for Dow.
See, the trick to that, it's a what they call a jailbreak screen. Mm-hmm. And so the idea is you got to run to the football. You can't run upfield. You have to find the football, run to the football, then you can go upfield.
Miller juts forward. He's looking downfield. He's under heavy pressure. He's running. There's a flag on the play. Miller, the ball's complete for the first down yardage, but I think this one's coming back. I'm sure this is going to be a hold. Miller was under heavy duress, and I think his lineman was just trying to save him here.
Midland put a good rush on, flushed Miller out of the pocket.
Great play by Miller.
Great play to keep it going. Did an excellent reception, got the first down, but it's going to come back. And it's going to come back a long way. Again, that's a spot foul. I really object to the spot foul.
Yeah.
I think it's just way too
severe of a penalty.
It is a severe penalty. It's a 20, it's a 20 to 30 yard penalty sometimes. Well, it's just too rough.
It turns a third and 11 to a third and 27. Yeah, so all the way back to the 40-yard line.
Pass interference is not. It used to be a spot foul. Mm-hmm. Now it's not. 10 yards is 10 yards. 10 yards is a lot.
Miller back to pass. He's got time this time. Throws downfield. Goes high. Rob had his hand on it. Knocked away by Russell. Would not have been a first down anyway, but it would have improved field position for the Dow High punt. But a promising drive for Dow stalls here. And Max Kidd, number 7, will go back to do the punting duties for the Chargers. DeLong and Williams back deep to receive for Midland High. Kidd, an excellent punter and an excellent kicker for Dow High. 4:38 remaining in the first quarter. It's a high, short kick. Takes a Dow bounce, and it will come to rest just inside the 30-yard line. And so Midland will take over. 0-0 here, but there has been a whole lot of action in this first quarter.
A whole lot of action, and really, except for the long run by Williams, Dow has dominated the first quarter up to this point. But Dow has shot itself in the foot twice. It's got to get its act together in order to keep this game going. Midland has played excellent defense, though.
Dow High defensive front, Austin Acker, 56, number 61, Ryan Shannon, 72, Matt Molesky, 62, Nolan Pitt also in there. Gross is going to keep the ball. He's got room to run. Just puts his head down and drives forward for the first down. Good strong run by the senior, Tanner Gross, out to the 41.
This is a good run. He finds a little bit of a seam. Linebacker gets lost, then gets blocked. See, the threat of Will Williams is so devastating. I mean, linebacker went right after Williams, which is what he should do.
Right.
So where's the other linebacker? Where's the safety? That's what you say to yourself. Where are you guys?
Williams has the carry. Oh, he's corralled down by the neck. Very physical tackle by the Chargers. Austin Acker on the tackle. Going to take another look at this one.
Corey McLaughlin.
Corey McLaughlin on the tackle. Excuse me. Good hard tackle. And it's a 4-yard gain for Midland. Williams again cuts to the right side. And it's going to be close to the first down. A good tackle there by Loria. He looked like he was about ready just to explode towards the sideline, but Loria hung on, hauled him down shy of that first down. The ball's right at midfield, third and one for the Chemics. And this is where we'll see Midland was able to assert themselves in the last game.
Michael Alexander's come into the game, and So you know it's going to be some sort of a power.
And Jordan Wilson.
Jordan Wilson. So this is going to be probably a power left and unbalanced right. So we're looking to cut back.
Williams got the first, drives ahead for about three.
Good job by the offensive line driving them out of there.
First down, Midland High.
Again, third down conversions are crucial here.
Mention those offensive linemen. And also 83 Alex Welter is a kind of a fullback tight end type position. Extra blocker for the Chemex. He's had a terrific season as well. This time he's lined up at the left tight end spot. Gross is keeping it. Got a lead blocker. Gross still on his feet down the right sideline. Finally tackled. But a big gain.
See, there's no answer for Gross. I mean, you're in that power. The linebacker goes to the inside, gets caught inside. Here comes the guard around the corner, gets a somewhat of a block, and then comes down around the corner. You know, here's Gross getting big yards.
Richard on the tackle.
Big, big run.
All the way down to the 25-yard line. Gross having an outstanding season in his own right, over 1,500 yards passing, 11 touchdowns against 7 interceptions. Williams. Keep pounding it, drives ahead. Going to get close to 10 on the first down play, a little bit short.
Does he have a feel for the hole or what? That hole was blocked up, and it creased opened to his inside, and he just broke it back into that hole.
And the,
he has wonderful feet.
The thing about him, Coach, is he's not a big guy. He's known for his speed, but he's got that low center of gravity, and he runs with power too.
Well, he's unique in that he doesn't have to tell his feet what to do. They're already there.
This is Alexander on the tech carry in for the score. So Midland mixes it up. The quick handoff to Michael Alexander. He busts up the middle, caught the Chargers by surprise, and the Chemics strike pay dirt. Everybody's looking at number 5. And 21 had the ball, and he is one tough fella to bring down. Hit inside the 5, but drives ahead, and Midland strikes first. Power running game. And Midland scores with a minute 36 remaining. Philip Wandor, the extra point is good. And the Chemics go on top 7-0. So the formula that Midland's used the last two games where it's just pound it, pound it, pound it. Use that great offensive line, those fullbacks, and it pays off here again in the first quarter. Let's see it again, quick handoff.
Little trap block, got to the linebackers, got to the down linemen. Ear got downfield, got in the way of the safeties, and Alexander just overpowered whoever was back there.
Like Porter on a trap block and sealed off nicely, and Alexander just driving ahead. They have used both Alexander and Wilson. They'll throw in a carry here or there for those guys just to try to keep the defense honest, and both those players run very hard and can pick up some tough yardage.
Yeah, I'll tell you, so far in his first quarter the touchdown was great. But I've been real impressed with Dow's play in the future. Their defense is just still not physical enough. They just got to get more physical. Their linebackers got to get more physical. They can't be blocked. But I'm impressed with Dow coming out offensively and moving the football. If they hadn't completed as many penalties, they may have moved the ball down a little further.
He's on the return for Dow. Good hard run by Mason Hayes. Brings it out to about the 24-yard line. And Dow will take over. Moved the ball pretty well in their last possession, but the penalties really stalled that drive. But like you said, it is encouraging for Dow here in that 2 weeks ago, Nothing really went well at all.
2 weeks ago, they had nothing.
And
now they're at least out there.
And it, you know what it looks like is they wanted to have another crack at this game.
Exactly.
And show that one, that wasn't the real Dow High team. And so far, we're seeing that real Dow High team. Caleb Richard on the handoff. He's met. It is stuffed.
Richard's blocker here.
Few chemics in on that play, led by Ben Luzar, number 53.
Ben Luzar really closed that hole fast.
Good chance on the initial hit.
So a chance in there on the stop for Midland High as well. Second and eight for Dow High. Three wide outs out to the right. Two to the left. Miller looking for that quick pass. He's got it. I believe that's Richard. It is. He drives ahead for the first down. Good hard run after catch. And there's a late flag. That's going to be on Dow High. Late after the play. Late block. So after that big first down, they'll probably still get the first down, but it'll move it back 15 yards. They are talking to
it could
Miller.
Be on, it could be on.
Maybe it's not a, on Dow. It is on Dow. Just explaining it to Miller. It is a first down.
First down on reception.
But instead of the ball being at the 37, we'll march back to the 22. And Dow effectively will start this drive over.
And shoot yourself in the foot. I mean, that was a silly penalty.
Yep. Frustration penalty. Big crowd here tonight at the Midland Community Stadium for this rematch. This is the 46th meeting between these two crosstown rivals. 44 years they've been playing ball. 46 games. This is the second time they've met in the postseason. Clock running down here on the first quarter. Miller's going to keep it. He's got room to run. Cuts to the outside. Good block there. And so a nice pickup out to the 31. Mason Hayes, a nice block leading the way.
Miller is extremely elusive. You just can't. You got to have one guy on him and two other guys covering him. This is going to be the end of the quarter.
Well, up to the 30-yard line as the first quarter comes to an end. So Midland High on top, 7-0. You're watching this Midland High Dow High football game on MCTV 97 on Charter Communications. You can also find this game on Channel 99 through AT&T's U-verse. The game will be cablecast on the following dates and times: Friday, November 8th at 11:30 p.m., Saturday, November 9th, and Sunday, November 10th at 9 a.m. and 8 p.m. And then after this weekend, the game will be shown on MPS-TV 98. Check the Sunday Midland Daily News and the Midland Public Schools website at www.mps.k12.mi.us, as you can see on your screen. For more dates and times, this game will also be shown on the school's YouTube channel. The coverage of this game was made possible in part with donations from Essexville Electric and the Production Directors of America. And so now high offense back on the field, switching ends. And like I said, they got to be encouraged here. First game, nothing went right. Dow has moved the ball here. Just got to clean up some of the penalties and turnovers. Have been it's tough to beat a team the caliber of Midland High when you make mistakes like that. So I'm sure Coach Watkins on the sideline imploring his team, just got to clean things up and they'll be fine. Miller's going to keep it again off to the right side. Tripped up, but he's going to get the first down. And that was Jared LaChance, senior on the tackle. He's number 20. But Dow moves the chains, the ball just touching the 34-yard line. Brandon Delaney, number 66, now in on the defensive line for Midland. Only one down lineman in that formation. Quick, they tried that quick bubble screen or jailbreak screen there, and that one's incomplete. Travis McNally, the intended receiver.
They're just not syncing up right on that one. That's the third time they've tried it. Third time's been unsuccessful. First time they tried it, it was a good pass, the receiver dropped it. Last two times is just been off mark.
You can see why they may go to that because it's got a lot of potential.
It's
going to
be big. If they get it, it's going to be big.
So Mike Robb, 85, and Mason Hayes out to the right here. Cook far out to the left. Miller, kind of a fake pass, but
Luzar
makes the play. He doesn't
right
buy any of
it.
Now there's a late flag again behind the play. Richard Stout, extracurricular activity. We'll see what the call is this time.
Michael Alexander.
It's indicating that somebody shoved another player down.
It's going to be against Midland.
It sure looks that way, doesn't it?
Yep.
Yeah, personal foul Midland. So 15 yards it went back against Dow, come right back against Midland. So it's kind of a Statue of Liberty.
Statue of Liberty screen, and
Luzar sniffed it out. Alexander there also.
Right.
First and 10 at their own 47-yard line.
There's a little bit of chippiness going on down on the field. And the umpire made the correct call, and the officials are doing a really good job. If you have officials to let it go, you're going to have a lot of trouble.
Pitch to Richard. Finds the outside. He's still on his feet. He's got the first down. Still driving ahead down to about the 33-yard line. Great run by Caleb Richard.
See, this is the key. Caleb Richard is the key, which will open up Miller. That's an outstanding block out on the corner.
Hey, Rob.
And now you've got Miller in open space, or Richard in open space, and he is a good runner.
Dow High on the move again. Like a sideline warning against the Chemics. So first and 10 for Dow. About 11 minutes remaining in the half. Trying to respond to that Midland touchdown here with a touchdown of their own. Miller's going to keep it. Lead blocked by Richard, and a good first down pickup for Miller. He gets those quick feet moving.
He does, and it's a great block by Richard to make the play. That's a good motion. Everything's going in front. It's actually a quarterback draw.
Yeah. Just about 8 yards on the play. And there's another flag on the play.
It's against Dow.
Ball start. Takes away that big first down run.
You remember in the first game the number of false starts that Dow's wideouts had? And to me, there's no excuse for that, because the rule you tell your wideout is you're not going anywhere until you see the ball move. Get yourself set, look in. When the ball, you can't hear the snap count. So when you see the ball move, you move. Otherwise, you're not moving.
So instead of second and 2, it's going to be first and 15, back to the 33.
In my mind, so far, there hasn't been a penalty that hasn't been deserved. Mm-hmm. You know, sometimes penalties occur because you're really given an honest effort, and you block a guy in the back, and things happen. But you don't jump off sides. You don't punch another person. You don't shove another person down. Those are just...
It's another waving off the flag.
All right, this is kind of interesting.
You don't see that every day. Penalty had already been assessed. Miller was discussing something with the official, and then he went over and talked to Coach Watkins, and he convinced the official that nothing was amiss there. So,
well, you're allowed to be in motion. You can be in motion as long as you continue in motion. That's not a false start, but you can be in motion.
So, well, anyway, it'll be, we'll probably call it second and three here. Miller alone in the backfield. Richard takes the handoff, trying to get a right end. Oh, what a play by Luzar. It looked like Richard was going to break the tackle around. Luzar just grabbed jersey and held on long enough for his teammates to come and finish it off.
So far, this is really a play by Luzar, and nobody out there to block him. And you're going to see, there he is right there. There's nobody to put their hands on him. And you just can't do that.
Great effort.
Great effort by Luzar. He's playing a spectacular first half.
He really is. Third and eight. Big play here in this game. Miller back to pass. He's got plenty of time. Looks down the middle. He's got his man all the way down inside the 5-yard line. It's Justin Cook. Cook's come up with some big plays here in the early goings.
This is a great play. It's, again, that same seam route that they ran earlier. He's in the in-between. Safeties didn't get there. And he breaks a tackle and then almost breaks another one.
All the way down to the 2-yard line. Sophomore Justin Cook. Quick snap on the quarterback sneak and no indication. I think he's going to be a little short. The Chargers thought he was in. But he's going to be just shy of the goal line.
He can't be too shy. Oh, wow, that point is right on there.
That is close.
It's first and an inch. Second and an inch.
I wouldn't be surprised if we saw that again. Miller, a good runner. Sometimes you do that quick count. And,
it's called a silent sneak.
You only need to get about an inch. But he's not over center.
This is good. Probably
not gonna... yet. Now he's under center. He does sneak it, and there was timeout was called by Dow.
God.
Was the good call. Miller just snuck up under center to drive ahead, but timeout had been called, and so we'll go back to second and goal. 9:06 remaining.
Well, I think the sideline saw a little bit of confusion and wanted to make sure they didn't fool around with getting the touchdown.
Miller, he's a dangerous runner as well. Over 100 yards rushing in the playoff game last week. He had 27 rushes on the year. He has picked up 652 yards and 10 touchdowns, including that playoff game. And so Jason Watkins, head coach, talking things over with his offense. Also assistant coaches Keith Schulte, Phil Legum, John Streeter. Excellent coaching staff for Dow High. Both teams blessed with great coaches. Eric Mettner at the helm for Midland. Here we go, second and goal. This time Miller in the shotgun. He's going to kind of goes back and forth. And handoff, and I don't think he's in.
I don't think he's in either.
That was to McNally. And Midland holds.
Richard, the ball player.
Great stand by the Chemics on that play. And so McNally Yep. Alexander got into the backfield, held on, and then pushed back by several other Chemics. Great play by Alexander. Third and goal from the one. Same play. McNally and touchdown. He only had to get a couple of inches. This time it's successful. And Dow High on the board. McNally with the touchdown.
And this just got in. This was this has really been a great goal line stand by the Chemics, and McNally made a great little cut and then just fell into the end zone.
Kid for the extra point. It is up. And it is good, and we are all tied up 7-7. A little over 8 minutes to go in the second quarter. Whole different story here than it was from 2 weeks ago. Midland dominated from start to finish. This time it has been a slugfest, back and forth, and really both teams playing their game. Midland
exactly.
That power,
both
and
games.
Dow mixing it up, the run and the pass, and been a tremendous ball game here so far.
Well, the fact that Midland gave up in four downs 2 inches, and the 1 inch was enough to get into the end zone. I mean, that's in essence what it's all about. But Dow has played much, much better this first half. You know, the other thing, Dave, and this is something that happens, and as coaches we all worry about it, you defeat a team by the mercy rule. Sometimes you start to look ahead and you start to say, okay, got Muskegon and Lowell next week. Mm-hmm. And you kind of overlook the fact, you know, no matter how hard you practice, you're still looking ahead. All of a sudden, the other team sneaks up and kind of bites you a little bit.
Well, Dow no slouch. 8-2 on the year, having a tremendous season. Kickoff goes into the end zone. Cooper catches it, but it will be a touchback, and Midland will take over on their own 20-yard line. Dow High, through the regular season, through the nine games, had the number one offense in the Saginaw Valley League North. 3,929 total yards, ranked number one. They also had the number two defense in total defense, 2,655. Midland High number one in that category at 2,274. Dow and Midland, the top two scoring teams in the Saginaw Valley North this season. So a lot of firepower on both sides of the ball. Gross finds Williams on the completion. Oh, great tackle. Had a lot of green in front of him. And McNally able to grab him around the legs. It's a big first down play on the Williams reception out to the 40-yard line. But great tackle there by McNally.
You cannot allow Williams to be one-on-one with anybody. Take a look. There is nobody underneath, nobody in front. Williams catches the ball, nothing underneath. Now you got it. Now you got a one-on-one. There's the missed tackle. And Caleb Gandy's been really good on that, but you just don't allow Williams to go one-on-one with you.
This time, nowhere to go for Williams on first down. Good defensive play. For the Chargers, Ryan Shannon in on the stop. It'll be no gain for Williams, second and 10. Williams had that big play on the big run on the first play from scrimmage, and he's been chipping away, but except for that that first play, Dow doing a pretty good job containing him. Gross, back to pass, caught by DeLong. Good, strong effort. He caught it
yes,
at
it
the
was.
45, was hit back, but then drove ahead before Richard able to bring him down at the 45.
DeLong's a pretty nice looking sophomore.
He is.
He's going to be a good player. He's an excellent defensive back and really is a very good receiver.
Third and four. For Midland. DeLong with 19 catches in the regular season for
again, Williams out here by himself.
Gross looking right. He's got ear. First down. Still on his feet. Down to the Dow 45. Here, Midland's top receiver on the season, as we had mentioned. 41 catches in the regular season. Big target is ear. And so, after defensive stands of several possessions, Midland went marched down and scored. Dow marched down and scored. Midland on the move again. Williams to the right. Spin move, but held up nicely. After about a three-yard gain, it was Contardi and McNally on the stop for Dow.
Good closing by Dow. Good closing.
That was one of those danger plays where Williams gets a little room and gets a spin. A lot of times he's able to break free, but good defensive play by the Chargers.
Well, immediately I'm already seeing it. Both teams are tackling in space very well. They're keeping their shoulders square. They're keeping their feet on the ground, doing a really good job, both teams.
Well, they're the fullback in front of Williams. Williams gets the handoff. Another nice tackle. For Dow, it's McNally again. McNally having a great game here for Dow so far. It's going to be third and six for the Chemics at the Dow 41. 5:20 remaining in the second quarter.
These third down conversions are the key to the success of either team. And this is a big one, because if you don't make this one, you're going to punt. Right. Well, you're going to punt and you're going to get the ball back inside the 20-yard line. So this is such a big, big possession for Midland right here, this third down.
Powerhouse backfield. Williams takes the handoff, and he spins ahead. It looks like he's going to get just enough for the first. What a run.
The spin
by Williams.
Phenomenal.
That wasn't a – ooh, they moved it back. Changed the spot.
I don't understand that spot.
I don't know about that.
Because
it can't be right.
He made the cut inside, and here comes the move right there. That's really not a bad spot.
No, actually, I think it's
a good spot.
It just was moved back from where the initial spot was.
Right.
So it's going to be fourth and inches. Dow had to gain inches for the touchdown, and they did. Now Midland needs inches to move the chains here. And Williams is going to get the first. They go off that right side. And that Schnurr, the guard, and Stern, the tackle, they've gained a lot of yards the last three games running off that right side.
That's the only place to run right now. I'd make a steady diet of right side. Stern and Dostal are road graders. That was a good run, good hard effort on that third down play by Williams to get as far down as he did.
First down, Midland at the 32. This time, it's Wilson just driving ahead. Are you kidding me? What an effort by Jordan Wilson.
Jordan Wilson refused to go down. The Midland line kept it going, and Dow standing up. And so now there's good surge. Now he gets through the chute with somebody in front, and you can see the Midland line is still blocking. And that's what makes it. And now here comes the crowd, what I call the crowd, which you get the rugby scrub.
Wow. Great effort. Williams bounces it, cuts it back up. Spin, still on his feet, all the way down to the 12-yard line. Twice it looked like he was coming down, but drives, spins, drives, moves the chains. Midland first down in the 12.
Superior effort by Will Williams right there. He is so elusive. This is a very good move here.
Great seal block by
Fisher
Wilson.
Fisher comes out and does a great job of blocking.
Oh. This is Alexander driving ahead. Touchdown, Midland High. Holy cow, those last three runs were just a battle of wills. Three different players. Michael Alexander, nice jut
gets
right
up
there
into
find
the
shoot. Hole.
There's an arm tackle, trying to pull
ahead,
him back.
Hit at the six-yard line.
And watch the drive.
Would not go down.
Terrific run. That's two touchdowns for Alexander. And both of them on power runs.
Wando for the extra point. It's up and it's good. Wander, tremendous leg, and Midland goes on top 14-7. What a ball game do we have here going at Midland Community Stadium.
See, I maintained earlier in the week when asked about this game, I said this game is a halftime game. What will happen if Midland blows out Dow early? It's over. But if Dow can get in, and this is a great run here. We're going to look at this by Alexander again.
Well, good little move
there.
In there.
Yeah, it was
a
great move to get up into the chute. And then you'll see some grab tackling. And you got to tackle Alexander somewhere around the knees or lower because he's way too powerful for a smaller defensive back. He looks for people to hit.
Initially hit at the 10, and he just drove forward. So impressive run consecutively by Wilson,
okay, next up.
And then Williams, and then Alexander.
Next up, Dow High.
Dow
High,
gonna, your turn,
it's
Dow.
Your turn. We could see this kind of a ball game where the defenses are going to be on your heels.
A little over 3 minutes to go in the second quarter. Dow received the kickoff here. Plenty of time for their offense to score. They can move that ball down the field quickly.
See, my thought in this game is that stats mean nothing. It's all going to be about turnovers. It's all going to be about possessions.
Jason Hayes on the return, and he's brought down just past the 20-yard line. Alexander in on the tackle along with Luke White, number 85. Alexander.
Well, if I was still coaching and I was working on special teams, I'd have four guys assigned to Alexander because he makes every tackle on the kickoffs. You just watch. He makes every single tackle. So, you got to block Alexander. I mean, it's just very simple. Find 21, block him. If one guy can't do it, get two. Two guy can't do it, get three.
Miller, quick pitch to Richard, and he drives ahead.
There's just too many people standing up for that play.
Belson on the tackle for Midland. Going to pick up about four on the play.
Gain of three.
About to the 25, we'll call it, so a three-yard pickup. Clock is running. New feature on our broadcast tonight to have the game clock on display. Swing pass to Richard. And be a little shy of the first down. Decent pickup there.
See, you got a little situation going on here. And that is that Dow's wideouts are not blocking as well as they have. And this is a credit to Midland's defensive backs. They are running to the football. And Dow's blockers can't get there fast enough. Midland secondary is.
Miller on third one. No, it's not going to happen. Great defensive play. That was Cody Snyder. Another big play for Midland. Decision time here. Fourth down.
No,
going to have to punt,
it's
don't
a punt.
You?
Oh, yeah. There's no
30
decision.
30-yard line.
Yeah, you got to.
I mean,
punt.
It's tempting because you just want to.
You
want to
keep it going, but this is crucial time right here. This is not the time for the faint of heart. You got to kick the ball.
If Dow can go into the locker room 14-7, really playing an even game, I'm sure they'll be. They would take that. kid high. Booming kick. Great punt. Fair caught by DeLong. Good boot by Kidd.
See, and I think that was a great catch by DeLong. It was a great decision to
catch it.
Fair catch it and catch it. You know, not only fair catch it, but also catch it.
If you don't catch it there, that could cost you another 10 yards.
I like to tell you, I watched practice a couple weeks ago and watched DeLong kick or Kidd kick, and I thought, this is a very difficult ball to catch because it has a way of kind of floating up there, mm-hmm. and then it turns over on you, and it's not much fun to catch. And that was a great move by DeLong to catch it, in a better move to fair catch it. Most guys are afraid of that. I got to tell you, most deep guys, they're afraid of that ball.
First and 10, Chemix. Cooper and DeLong split out wide to the left.
This is a decoy out here.
Gross is going to keep it. Still on his feet. Big gain on first down. Around the left edge. Still on his feet. All the way down to the 36-yard line.
That was a play by design that they spread him out to the moon. So it takes out the safety, takes out the halfback. They blocked the linebacker, and now the wideouts are able to get a piece of everybody out there, and Tanner Gross breaks down and comes down inside the 30-yard line, inside the 40-yard line.
Good seal block by Stern out there to create that extra yardage. Finally, Caleb Gandy able to knock him out of bounds, but that's a big play on first down. 52 seconds to go. Midland getting close to field goal range.
Find Will Williams.
Here has it. And he's trying to get out of bounds, and no, the clock will run. Good job by Hayes. Going to force Midland to call timeout. Hayes did a good job of hauling him down before Ear was able to get out of bounds. So Coach Mettner will call timeout. The scoreboard shows no timeouts remaining, but I think that's only their second, isn't it? They have Dow for three, but I know they called one down on the goal line. Maybe the scoreboard charged Midland with that timeout.
But the scoreboard never lies. The scoreboard never lies.
We'll see. Ball on the 30, and Philip Wandor is the place kicker for Midland, and he has got a big leg. Both teams blessed with great kickers. Wanderer, through the regular season, had 42 extra points and 7 field goals.
There's enough time right now for 5 plays, 8 seconds of play. That's what you're trying to think about right now. You're thinking, okay, I can get 10 yards per 10 seconds. That's my rule. So you got plenty of time here. Just don't panic.
3 wideouts to the left. It's Williams in the slot. Keep your eye on him, number 5. Gross back to pass. Looks downfield. He's looking for Williams, and it's caught! Touchdown, Chemix. Said, "What? You cannot let him get free. He's dangerous." Beautifully thrown ball by Tanner Gross on the money, who's actually pretty well covered, but dropped it right into his arms.
Remember what I said? Where's Williams?
Came from the slot.
Came right down. He got bumped, but not controlled. And at this point, right here, he just over McNally.
McNally may even have gotten a fingertip on that ball. But dropped right to Williams, and Midland just like that.
Well, you got to pick your poison. Are you going to stop Williams, or are you going to stop here? Those are your two poisons.
So Wandor's extra point is good. And quick turn of events here. After that punt, 2 big plays. The big run by Gross to get it into Dow territory, and the Gross to Williams, touchdown pass, and Midland goes up 21-7. That's a heartbreaker
for
the Chargers.
That was a great pass. I mean, that was right on the money, and Williams made the break away from McNally to make the play. It was a great pass and tremendous protection.
Oh,
the thing that I'm watching tonight is that Dow is committed to stopping Williams running. Okay, when Williams is not in the backfield,
he's not going to run it.
He's not going to run it. I mean, so Dow is still playing run defense. And you got to knock, in my mind, you got to knock the quarterback off his mark a little bit. You can't let the quarterback just stand back there. Wait, I mean, quarterbacks are going to find open receivers. These are good quarterbacks. They find the receiver.
That offensive line that time with great pass coverage. Fisher, Dostal, Rapana, Stern, Schnurr.
See, I think Tanner, that he's been underrated all year. You know, I think that there have been some other quarterbacks in our league that are pretty good, Miller included. Mm-hmm. But he has done the job whenever he's been asked. You know, when you think about it, Midland's only lost one game. And that was a 50-42 game.
Right.
I mean, yeah. Your quarterback gets you 42 points. You got to say to yourself, hey.
Probably ought to win.
I should have won this ball game by at least 20. But, you know, Mount Pleasant gets 50.
And on the kickoff, Dow was offside. You don't see that very often with the receiving team being offside. It was kind of a squib kick by Midland. But that front line of Dow was a little closer than that 10-yard mark that they need to be. And so Wandor will kick it off from the right hash once again. Let's see if we see the squib kick again here. Looks like they're expecting it. Little pooch kick, and it's caught. Good job, really, by
Luke DeLong.
Luke DeLong on the stick. It was really a good heads-up play. Robert Ellebrack, number 10, had to run up and catch that. He knew he was going to take a lick.
Right.
But he caught it and took the blow. But Luke DeLong leaned on the lumber. He may have been shaken up a little bit on that hit.
First and
10
from their own 27-yard line.
Ball on the 28 for Dow. 32 seconds remaining. See if they try to.
They'll try that little seam. I'm sure they're going to try that seam rod again.
Miller's going to keep it, trying to find room to run. Judson Head runs into the umpire and goes down. Oh, boy. That's a tough break for Dow.
You know what's impressive? The umpire never moved. He stood his ground and knocked Miller down, and the umpire never moved. I mean, he was like a statue. Watch the umpire. He is not going to move. And, you know, you've got to have your right in there. Here it comes right here, and he makes the move, and boom. That's a hit. That is the hit of the game. I got to tell you.
You don't see that every day. It's a tough spot for that umpire to be in because the play is going right. You don't really expect it's going to suddenly come back your way. And he tried to go
the
other way.
He lowered his shoulder and stuck him. Oh, yeah. We've got
to
give
the
umpire a little bit of credit. That's quite a play. I've never seen that.
I haven't either.
I mean, I've seen him get out of the way, but I've never seen him put a stick on somebody.
Tough break for Dow and Miller.
Put a helmet on the guy.
So second and 5 for Dow. Miller's going to keep it again. He's got a little hole. He's got the first down. Drives ahead just close to the 40. And we'll move the chains with 15 seconds to go. I was going to have to. We're going to have to throw the ball downfield here. Nope, it's going to be to Richard, and he is brought down. Michael Alexander again with a sure tackle. That was going to call timeout. Excellent play by Alexander. He is a football player. Richard looked like he had some room to run, but Alexander closed the ground quickly. It will be the last play, barring a defensive penalty here. Dow High's calling the timeout. And they'll not going to be able to throw it all the way to the end zone. You see a little trickeration here.
Might see something, but Midland's going to be playing in a prevent defense. They're already back there quite a ways and allowing Dow to throw anything they want underneath.
Well, they may just stand 3 yards on about the 10-yard line back here. Long ear, McInerney way back deep. Six guys playing 15 yards off the line of scrimmage.
Here is the question we ask, where is Caleb Richard? That's who they want to throw to.
He's actually in the left slot, yep. Same place that Williams was in on that last touchdown for Midland. Difference being there's a lot of blue jerseys deep defensively. So they put a little more time on the clock, 6 seconds instead of 3.6. Miller back to pass. Some pressure. Uncorks the pass, and it's going to be intercepted by Austin Ear. The time will expire in the half. He tried to find Rob, and I'm going to guess he's going to try to pitch it back to Richard possibly, but nevertheless picked off by Ear, and the teams will head to the locker room. A very entertaining first half, and big play by Midland right at the end there.
Right at the end. That's a
completely shifted momentum.
That does change momentum. 14-7 is a lot different than 21-7, although I will say this. I felt if Dow went in at halftime down 14, that it was still a ball game.
Okay.
If it got beyond 14, then it was not going to be a ball game. And really, except for that last little play, it could have been easily 7.
Right.
So this is still a pretty good football. You know, 14 is manageable. 21 is not. And now you're desperate with 21. So
Coach Watkins takes his troops into the locker room to figure out how to cut into that 14-point deficit. And we're back here for the second half at Midland Community Stadium. Both teams back on the field doing their warm-ups as we get ready to kick it off here shortly. And we're going to take a look at some of the first half highlights here. And there were plenty of highlights in this game, Coach.
It's quite a first half. This is the first one. Caleb Richard runs a beautiful run, fumbles the ball, and Midland gets it right back. And Williams comes right back and makes a fantastic run. And really, this is a touchdown-saving tackle by Contardi. And this is a throw right over the middle. Great catch by Cook. Later on, they'll come back and do that same one. And look how elusive Miller is. He comes down, makes a great throw, gets the first down to Rob. And this is just a power run by Alexander. Just get out of my way, run. That's exactly what that was. And again, here's Richard. And I think Richard's the key to the second half. You got to get him the football. And you got to get him the football where he can do some space work. This is, again, that same seam route. And you can see right there, Cook catches it, and really an excellent tackle by DeLong. And this is the touchdown, which was a struggle. I mean, a real struggle to get 1 inch. And this is a play right here. Williams catches the ball. You got to find Williams. You can't let him have any space. And there is space right there. A spin. And this, again, is an excellent run here. You take a look at the power Wilson's running. And here comes the scrum. And this is Williams on a great cut. Look at that. And then, again, little jab step to the side. And, you know, right there, that was a big touchdown. But this is really a move here.
Gross gets out, gets around the corner, gets down the sideline, and surprisingly fast. And now here comes the touchdown throw. He gets his feet set, makes a nice throw over the top. Williams catches the ball. Great touchdown. And that might be the touchdown that breaks Dial's back, because I didn't want to show that one. I'm not even going to talk about that one right there. I'm talking over that little play right there, because Miller's never going to live it down.
No, I mean,
I heard of playing with 12 guys on the field, but that's ridiculous. Okay. Now, let's take a look at some stats for this half. I mean, you got Williams rushed for 13 for 105. Now, if I'm Dow High, that's very good. I'm keeping Williams under that 200 mark, and I'm hoping that I can maybe give that same look in the second half. He had two receptions for 49 yards and a touchdown. Gross was 5 of 6, which is terrific, for 71 yards and a touchdown. And he rushed 3, and this is crucial. Of course, big one was in there. He had 3 rushes for 66. For Dow, Miller is 7 of 11 for 78 yards, and Cook had 3 receptions for 58 of those 78. Richard rushed 10 times for 45 yards, and Miller rushed 8 times for 31. Now, there were a number of Richard's rushes that were sent called back because of what I call pretty stupid penalties. I never think holding is a stupid penalty, but it is a stupid penalty when you hold behind the runner.
Doesn't
affect
the play.
I mean, I had guys. I had a kid one time came up to me and he said, "Coach, I'm really sorry. I got called for holding twice tonight." And I said, "How many plays did we run?" He said, he said 55. I said, "You were 53-2. I said, "That's a win. That's a win. You held on every play. They only called you twice." So,
the
ball's loose.
And Midland has it.
I think DeLong has it right there,
yes,
doesn't he?
Yes, he does. Midland has the football. The same squig kick.
No, it wasn't DeLong, but... recovery for the Chemex by Matt Nastasi.
You cannot,
it's identical to the opening kickoff of the game.
Exactly. You have to say to yourself, I'm going to put two guys on the 20-yard line and right on the numbers. And I'm going to, you got to stand. When you play Midland, this is a great kick. You just got to stand on the 20 and then move to the ball. And now they're not doing anything.
Stasi covers it on the 24.
Ellenbrick let it fall, and so did Richard. And that's, to me, that's a turnover right there. That is a monstrous. That's Dow's third turnover of the game. And now you give Midland the short field on the first possession.
Remarkable. It happened both kickoffs of this each half. Gross. Wide open his ear and in for the score. Play action pass, Austin Ear by himself. Gross does not make a mistake. Hits in between the 1 and a 1. And just like that.
Nobody covers Ear. He's playing tight end. He goes right down the backside.
A little bit on the play action.
And wide open. They bid on it. Ear's all by himself. Touchdown.
Oh, man.
Big, big play. Great call by Coach Methner.
Absolutely.
Great call.
Not expect, they have that full house backfield. They throw out of it for the score. Wandor's extra point is good. And 10 seconds into the half, Midland goes on top 28-7.
You know, I'm a great believer in what do you do in your possessions. So far, Midland has had 6 possessions and has scored the last 4. Dow held them off the first 2. And, of course, the first one was that same idea right here, that 4 kick. Now, here's the difference. Midland does that, and Dow fumbles the first time. Dow did it, and Midland scores right at first play. I mean, that's a 14-point turnaround right there. Just right there.
And so, the last minute of the first half, Midland scores. First minute of the second half, that's 14 points in about a minute spread, if you think about it.
It would not surprise me to see an onside kick right now. I mean, Dow is completely disorganized. this is the time when you would want to do it. To drive a nail in the coffin. This is perfect time when you want to do something like that. If you're going to do it, it takes guts to do it.
It would take guts to do it, especially with this Midland defense.
Something to look for.
Well, instead, they kick it deep. Hayes will take it and get out to about the 25-yard line. Just hauled down. Host of Kemick tacklers.
Now, you're not going to understand this and appreciate it, but there were two guys on Alexander, and he rode him out of bounds.
So, long Dement on the stop, among others. So Dow, this time, will take over on their own 26. But a big mountain to climb now, both on the scoreboard and momentum-wise. Miller's going to keep it. Oh, great move by Miller.
Terrific
to elude Alexander. Going to pick up about six or seven on the play.
Excellent block. And now that great little fake, and then got the move. And this is hard. This is 21 points, and this is where I always feel you've got to get back to 14. You got to figure a way to get back to 14 fast.
Big drive here for Dow. You got to figure. Richard, the ball carrier, tries to find the edge, showing some good speed down the right sideline, all the way down to the 40 before he's pushed out of bounds by Belson. Nice run by
a terrific run there.
Caleb Richard.
And right into the teeth of the defense. And then finally, I'm talking about these wide receivers. There's a block there on Wilson. An excellent block. Rob got kind of moved with Richard, set him up. And now we have Belson does bring him down.
Good seal block by Bradley Drankpool, number 63, the sophomore you mentioned, brought up from the JV. We were talking earlier, his dad played for you back in the day.
His dad
here
was
at Midland High.
Defensive end and played. It was an excellent pitcher for me. He thought he was an outfielder. Again, a terrific,
terrific
play right there. Good blocking.
Good hard running. DeLong brings him down, but a good pick up on first down.
The way Midland's defense is set right here, they can't stop that play for less than 5 yards. Now, does Dow have the patience to force Midland to close in a little bit? Sometimes you have to force teams to do something that they don't want to do. You can't always run into the heat of their defense.
What you got to like is after that quick score like that, you think maybe Dow will be demoralized, but Richard is just running hard here. Miller going deep. He's got his man. He's got it. And a quick move, and he's still on his feet all the way down to the 3-yard line is McNally. Good quick pass, and Dow knocking on the door.
See, there are seams in the Midland defense.
Nobody covering him.
The safety's supposed to get over. Got fooled. Ball was caught a little short. Good move there by McNally.
Yeah, it sure was.
And DeLong does make the tackle. DeLong makes a lot of tackles.
Nobody covered McNally at all down that sideline. Good recognition by Miller to find him. First and goal for the Chargers. And Dow jumps early. Ah. Turns a first and goal from the 3 to first and goal from the 8.
Those are just backbreakers. But then again, think about this, Dave. Even though that happens, now you have room to maneuver your offense.
Yep.
Most of the time, you get down inside the 5-yard line with these spread offenses, you're not very good. Midland does a great job. They get out of the spread and into the power. And they're willing to grind it right in. Dow doesn't have that. I mean, Dow is much better at scoring a touchdown from the space out here, yes.
So maybe it could be a plus here. We'll see. Oh, and another, it's going to be another false start. Richard moved a little bit early, too. So
this
now it's 10 yards back.
Not the right way. I mean, it's first and goal.
First and goal from the 12-yard line.
So you've gone from the 2 to the 12 on
without running a play.
Without running a play, right. I mean, there's one thing about giving yourself space, but it's another thing to give yourself the entire field.
Miller back to pass. He's got time. Fires, and it is incomplete. Tried to find McNally. And a quick out, trying to get those 10 yards back.
So you're forced now to throw the football. And you're forced to throw the football into coverage. And the worst part is, you know, that 28, if that's 21, I might kick a field goal here.
Right.
21-10. Now it's 28, I have to go. I need the touchdown.
Four receivers out to the right. They like to run out of this formation a lot.
The sideline is wide open.
Going down the middle, and it is broken up. Great defensive play. That was looped along. He was momentarily open, but he closed the gap and made contact right as the ball arrived to jar it loose.
I'll be interested. McNally. This could be a good no-call. That is a very
perfect
good
timing.
Very good no-call, because it could have been interference.
McNally on the quick slant just inside the end zone, and DeLong met him, bring up a third and goal from the 12. Richard in motion. Miller looking, he's got his man, draw. He drops it right at the goal line. Looking for Rob.
One thing, tall guys, they have a trouble catching the ball below their waist. This ball kind of dies. You see
yeah.
what? It's going to drop. See where it dropped? See, Rob's 6'5", almost 6'6". It's hard for a guy catching the ball down below his waist.
You know, and it was going downward by the time it
yeah,
got to him.
It was a duck by the time it got to him. It was quacking.
So fourth and goal. So this big play that got down to the 2-yard line. Now he's got to come up with a big play here. Miller fires, and it is caught.
Touchdown.
Justin Cook yep. on the touchdown, that same play.
That's the same play that they've converted two other times. It's a little seam route. Really surprises me that Midland doesn't have a guy right in the inside of it.
Just
it
a little
just
late.
Doesn't get over there.
Great pass. Great concentration by Cook, who's having a huge game. For Dow, that play has been their most effective play. So Dow needed that desperately, and Miller and Cook come through. 9 minutes to go in the third quarter. Extra point by Kidd is up and good. And so it's 21-14. So Dow responds after that devastating initial touchdown. We'll take a look at this touchdown
That's
one more time.
Run. Great pass, I mean, and an outstanding catch. Watch Cook makes the inside move, and he just catches it right over Luzar.
DeLong. DeLong
Luzar,
and Luzar, yeah.
Luzar's right there, and DeLong's on the inside. Mm-hmm. McInerney had a chance to come over there and make the play, but Dow ran four vertical and
right.
forced McInerney to stay in there.
Right, they had four on the other side just to kind of clear out some space for Cook, and impressive drive by Dow. They immediately respond and overcame a couple of those big penalties. And we have a ball game again.
Remember what I told you? Give them space. You got to have space.
Right.
And not have any. Dow has no fear. You know, they're not afraid to continue to air it out.
So here we go. This is the MHSAA playoffs district final game here. Midland
so now,
down, it's been a dandy.
So now are you thinking onside? I mean, that's what Midland's thinking.
Yeah, they're thinking it, but, boy, it seems a little early, doesn't it?
Never early.
Never early?
Never early. When you got it, you got it, you take it. Takes guts to call it, Dave, I got to tell you.
It is an onside attempt. Ball's loose. I think Midland recovered, but we'll see what the official indication is. It is Midland's ball. It took some guts. Good call, coach. And it had a chance. The ball was loose for a while.
It had a chance. This is a very good squibble. We call this the squibble. But see, you got to go on out and get people.
You have to wait until the ball
there
crosses
it is
the
right
line.
There. You got to let it get by there, and now you got to be ready to dive in.
Alex
and
Welter.
See, Dow guys weren't around it enough. Alex Welter made a good play.
Yeah, he saw the ball. He didn't hesitate and let the ball come to him. He went and got it.
Dow guys were too high.
And oh,
they're calling so, first touching at the 50, the Dow 49.
When you kick it center like that and slowly, you got to be careful that you don't accidentally touch
overrun
it.
The ball.
And it's tough because you have all those bodies and the ball's bouncing every which way. Couldn't really see it there. But you can see it come through and Welter pounce on it. So Midland will have good field position at the Dow 49.
Now, I've got to tell you, Dave, I wasn't a big fan of that right there because momentum's on my side. Time is on my side. 14 points is on my side. Everything's on my side. Let my defense do its business. And, you know, it's a, as I say, a gutsy call.
Gutsy call, absolutely.
I knew it was coming, though.
you called it.
I hate
it.
To say it. I knew you it was coming. I wanted to say don't think about doing that.
Second and eight. The Dow defense needs to rise to the occasion here. And try to get their offense the ball back once again. Dow secondary, Caleb Gandy, McNally, Skylar Cantardi, and Mason Hayes. And, oh, nice job. Caleb Richards shooting the gap and brings down Williams for a probably one-yard loss here.
That was
so
a very
third
good
and
stunt.
Long.
That was a good stunt by Caleb Richard.
Big play. And Dow defense being called on here. And so far, doing the job. We will see third and long, desperately wanting to force Midland to punt. Skylar Cantardi is leading tackler for Dow this season with 74 tackles. Jacob Loria, second with 57. Quick pitch left to Williams. Finds a little hole on his feet. He gets the first down. He had a chance to stop it, but those quick feet by Williams dart right ahead. The old Midland pitch. Got some good seal block downfield. He breaks that one tackle and dives ahead for about five more yards, and Midland moves the chains. Ball on the 34-yard line. The winner of this game goes on to face the winner of Lowell and Muskegon, who's also playing tonight. Williams right side. Caleb Richard again. Looks like his assignment is Williams here.
There's no question about it.
Five goes, you go, Mr. Richard. You're doing a great job so far. A one-yard loss. Second and 12 here now for the Chemics. Just a power formation, that's all it is. Williams still on his feet, finds a hole, first down, drives ahead off that right side.
Well, here's a very interesting thing. Caleb Richard goes out into the, you'll see Caleb Richard is now out here at the outside linebacker into power formation away from Williams. Well, Caleb Richard is going to make the tackle.
15 yards downfield.
Yeah. I mean, I'd just leave Caleb Richard in the middle and tell everybody else get out of the way. The guy's made a lot of tackles. He's a real football player. It's quite a matchup between Williams and Richard.
Yeah, this time it is going to be Wilson on the carry off the left side. Running behind Jacob Dostal.
Now, if you remember in the first game, Wilson
Fisher
broke that same playoff for almost a touchdown. Great run.
Second and three. Nice 7-yard pickup on first down. Coach Mettner gives the play to Gross. Midland traditionally, instead of signaling in, the quarterback always comes over to the coach just to get it directly, and heads back to the huddle. Just totally bunch formation. Gross is going to keep it. Goes on the right side. Good play. Mason Hayes to run him out of bounds. Looked like he had a chance.
Play just kept getting stretched out, and then you get a play.
Hayes finishes him off. No gain on the play. Bring up third and three for the Chemex. This time when he runs right like that, he has to come all the way across the field to get the play and then head back. Dow defense needs to stop. Could be four down territory, though.
This is Alexander. Oh,
it's Wilson. He's going to get the first down. Jordan Wilson. Fouls the block of Welter. And Richard on the stop, but not before Midland moves the chains again. Down to the just outside the 10, so they can get a first down.
First down, Midland High.
This has been some kind of quarter.
This
is some kind of quarter right here. But this quarter has been a slugfest.
Midland on top by two touchdowns. Dow impressively responding to cut it to those two touchdowns, but now need to make a stand. This time it's Wilson again, right up the middle, in for the touchdown. He saw there's a big hole there off the left side behind Rapanis and Fisher. And he just drove ahead.
And it just
barely even touched.
Beautiful job of blocking. Trap block up the center. Just beautiful.
Matt Schnurr with the trap, number 68. And
now that's a play that Midland, that Mount Pleasant ran against Midland all night long. That same play. And Midland, of course, smart enough to realize that's a good play.
So Philip Wandor. And Lynch, Ryan Lynch is the holder, number 15, and it's good again. He is so true on those extra points, and Midland goes on top, 35-14.
Now, Midland has scored on its last five possessions. Every time they've had the ball in the last five times, they have scored. Dow has scored two out of their last four possessions.
Which isn't bad,
but you've got to match possession for possession. You got to make a stop and force the other team to punt.
Try to get.
And right now, Dow has not been able to stop Midland.
Try to create a turnover or something, but.
See, right now, trading touchdown for touchdown doesn't get it.
So you want to be a star? You can sing, dance, play a musical instrument, or tell jokes? Then MCTV wants you. The Friends of MCTV are hosting the fifth annual Midland Shining Stars Talent Show on Saturday, December 7th. It's your chance to perform for a TV audience. To sign up, call MCTV at 837-3474. Email MidlandStars@yahoo.com. This is your time to shine on Midland Shining Stars. So Wandor. Take a short approach here.
It's going to be a short kick.
Oh, better be on their toes. It's that little pooch kick. This time it's going to be fielded by Hayes at about the 18. And he is swarmed under. Luke White in on that stop again. You see Luke White in a lot of those tackles, too, on those special teams over there.
Yeah,
on the right
but the
side.
Last guy underneath the pile is Michael Alexander.
Number 21. He just wreaks havoc.
He does. He does.
So here we go. Dow needs to respond again here. Backs against the wall. Here late in the third quarter. Miller going deep. He's got a man open. McNally's got it. Down the sidelines it goes. Only DeLong to beat, and he does. McNally, a beautifully thrown ball by Brennan Miller on the money. And McNally hauls it in and turns on the Jets.
Wow, what a throw, what a catch. And again, this is the spot where the Dow receivers are better than the Midland defender because of the zone. You know, you get in the open spots of the zone.
74-yard bomb. Well, I guess that answers whether Dow would respond or not. First play, they strike pay dirt. Extra point is good. The non-traditional approach there hits the crossbar and ricochets over. It's nevertheless is good. Take a look at the extra point again.
Now, you see, something happened. I'm going to tell you. Something happened before, and this happened in the first game, where he got involved in something other that knocked his concentration off. There's something that's going on between either the holder or the kicker, but in the first game, that happened again, and where he moved out of the way, took his concentration off, and made a bad kick. Now, that time, it was successful.
Right. Alec Marty is the holder. To keep in this game, that was a big extra point, if you think about it.
Huge
it's still
extra
just
point.
Is that two-touchdown game?
Two-touchdown game.
It's like Midland is protecting against that onside kick again. Five guys up front. I'll be surprised if we see it again.
Well, if they made it the first time, that'd have been good. I'd try a second, but not now. You've got to wait till the fourth quarter to do it again. And again, this is a good kicker. Make Midland go 80 yards.
Booming kick.
That's in the end.
Fielded by Williams at about the 5. And good coverage by Dow. It was Dimitri Stein on the tackle for Dow High, number 88. And so Midland will take over at the 22-yard line. 4:30 to go here in the third quarter. Well, you said earlier, what a quarter, and it just got even more exciting.
Still going. It's still going.
Back and forth. Great offensive performances by both teams here. 2 touchdowns apiece.
Again, I want to repeat, Midland has scored on his last 5 possessions. Now, they're in their power backfield. And this means we're going to eat the clock up
a little.
It's
Alexander. Well, oh,
almost.
He just tripped up. It was Cantardi on the tackle. And he may have saved a touchdown there because if he gets by Cantardi, we haven't really seen open field speed by Alexander,
see,
but he had room to run.
Dow's defense now has gotten out of its rhythm a little bit. And the guys up front are getting too much depth. You see where they're up? And when that happens, when you get up, all you're going to be doing is chasing.
This time it's Wilson. You're seeing a little more of Alexander and Wilson carrying the ball here in the second half, instead of just relying on Williams. It's going to be a little short of the first down, 3rd and 1. It could be a big play for the Dow defense. It's tough to stop this Midland running game and hold him to stop him on a 1
exactly.
1 yard.
You have to stunt. You have to catch him in the backfield.
This time it's Williams right side. He's got room to run. Uh-oh, there he goes. There he goes. Not going to catch him. And that is going to go. 69-yard run. Will Williams off that right side. He follows the 2 fullbacks and
now, again,
just explodes.
I'm going to tell you, see how Dow is up? See, everyone on Dow's team is up. And
well,
when
they're trying to
up,
stop the 1 yard.
They're up.
Look at that great blocking downfield.
Yeah. And now here goes Williams shooting through, and it's gone.
Nate Fisher pulling on the play with the block. And Williams just takes off. It's almost like ping pong back and forth. These two teams go. Wander's kick is up. Good. And it's 41-21. Dow High thinking, what do we have to do? We score. And just like that, Midland responds, and Dow comes back. So a three-touchdown game once again. Wow.
Six possessions in a row now. I mean, it's, you know, you're just scoring on every possession.
Well.
And you're not having, Midland has not punted tonight.
First possession.
First possession, that's right.
That was it, yep. And
Williams
punted it, yep.
Right.
And so the big play by Dow on the bomb responded with a huge run by Williams.
And that possession was the last possession Midland hasn't scored on. All the others, the first possession was the fumble on the kickoff, and then Williams punted, and from that point on, Midland scored on every possession.
And Midland's formation generally now is two tight ends.
Three backs. Hello, 1970.
And deal with it.
Hello, 1970.
Can you say Woody Hayes, Bo Schembechler?
Hello, 1970.
Well, it's hard to argue with it because it's been working.
It works.
So here we go. Another high, short kick.
Again.
Hits the ground. At the time, it's fielded by Hayes. On the left sideline, good return by Hayes. Out to the 30.
Hayes on return, flag on the
flag. Is a flag. And Tanner Diamant on the tackle this time.
Tanner Diamant on the tackle.
Maybe a hold back there.
Well, it was the most disastrous of the three holds that occurred. There were two holds that occurred further up.
And this one's the farthest back.
This one's the furthest back and will now cost you the return plus 10 yards.
You mentioned it's a spot foul.
Wow.
All the way back to the 9-yard line. So a long field to go here for Dow High, down by three touchdowns, 3 minutes to go in the third quarter. An action-packed third quarter. Ball batted down. Good defensive play by Colin Coltson. Coltson, outstanding player for Midland. He was a first-team All Saginaw Valley League North.
Well, let me say this. Right
pick.
Now, the Midland defense is smelling blood and are going to play at a little, you know, the penalty was big, but they're going to play at a little bit of a higher level intensity. Dow is going to struggle at this point simply because of that. You get enthused and you're ready to go.
Miller's going to keep it. Little hole up the middle. Good run again. It's been an effective play for Dow. He's going to pick up about five.
See, I honestly think they're willing to give Miller that play. They're willing to give it. They have enough guys that are coming up and in. So I think they're willing to give him that little play inside and take away anything big outside and deep.
Give him six on that last carry, third and four. Five receivers split out. He fires, he's got Rob wide open. Rob still on his feet, plows ahead to about the 33. Dow moves the chains. Bullet thrown by Miller.
See, I thought this was the place. These outside seams are wide open. The inside seam is open. What's not open is short, little curl. See, there's nobody there. You can't get into that. You can't play this defense and say, I got to cover everything. So you're going to give them those little seams that are out there. And you just got to take them. You just have to have the patience to take them.
Miller throws a nice ball.
Yeah, he does.
Here goes again. Batted down again. It's almost caught by Richard. It'll go incomplete. I think Colton got a piece of that one. Second and 10. Under 2 minutes to go here in the third quarter. Caleb Richard, the junior, is the running back. Miller's going to keep it. Not this time. Diamant met him in the backfield and hauled him down for a four-yard loss. Great play by Dement.
Well, it's a great play when you only have three guys rushing and you can't protect your quarterback. You got to protect that quarterback.
Brandon Delaney, 66, the defensive front. Midland usually just has one down lineman in their defense, if you notice that.
They've had it two times. Now, this time they didn't have any down linemen. They all got up.
Under pressure. He's going to try to keep it. Oh, that was just good contained by Midland. And he tried to get outside, but just not going to happen. The defense, Luzar over there, Alexander, and Snyder just strung out that play. Being up fourth down and 11, that was going to have to punt it. Maybe if he made it fourth and 5, you go for it there, but fourth and 11 is a pretty big chunk deep in your own territory. DeLong back to receive, kids punt, low snap, but a good kick again. And takes a Midland bounce, though. Comes back and will go out at the 44. So Midland with pretty good field position. The defense holds. And Dow defense has just got to come up with a way to stop Midland here. Midland effectively moving down the field. Mostly with power running, but they've also have gone deep a couple times for touchdowns. Two TD passes for Tanner Gross.
That was a really not a very good punt, but a lot of it had to do with the poor snap. Mm-hmm. The ball was low. It takes off. You're out of your rhythm. You're out of your point of attack, and as a result, you don't really get it all.
So here we go. This time, two receivers out to the left. That's DeLong and Ben Elliott, number 33. Gross is going to keep it. Cuts up for a nice gain. McNally on the stop along with Loria. But he's going to pick up a good 7 yards. Nice chunk on first down. Looked like Dow was going to be able to string that out, but Gross smartly cut it back up. And the fourth quarter comes to an end here with
Gross
Midland on top.
Gross made a nice little move in. Forced the linebacker to go in after him, and then he cut it out around him, and it was really a good play. Wow, Dave, that was some kind of third quarter.
Wow.
You know?
Back and forth. Great action.
5 touchdowns in that quarter.
Amazing. Well, the coverage of this football game is being produced by MCTV volunteers and staff. If you'd like to work on shows like this one, come to the next orientation studio training class. Cost is just $45, which includes the annual access user fee. Call 837-3474, as you can see on your screen there, or come down to MCTV Studio in the lower level of the Grace A. Dow Memorial Library. You can learn more about MCTV at www.midland-mi.org/MCTV, and you can follow MCTV on Facebook. So, end of the fourth quarter here of the district championship game, Midland versus Dow. It has been action-packed. Remember 2 weeks ago, Midland dominated the game from start to finish. This time, a much tougher battle.
Now,
it's been a great game.
This lineup is a decoy out here to the right, and Dow didn't go for it. Whenever you got three receivers that line up outside, or even two receivers that line up together outside the numbers, just don't worry about them. They're going to run the football somewhere else.
Ryan,
it's just too far away. You can't throw the ball that far.
Ryan Shannon with the big stop for Dow High. And it'll bring up third and six situation from the 48-yard line. I'm going to guess we won't see the trips right here on this play. We may see that power backfield. And yes, we do. Just that power formation. Go ahead and stop us. Williams, right side. He just tripped up. A big play, and Contardi saves the touchdown.
How smooth is Williams? Watch how smooth he runs. Just watch this. He gets up an edge, just smooth. See that rhythm? That was a beautiful run. It's just beautiful.
Fisher again pulling out there, but he had a huge hole and glides through it, takes off. Contardi saving the touchdown with a clock wheel run, ball into Dow territory. This time Alexander cuts up, still on his feet. Uh-oh, there he goes. Michael Alexander, his third touchdown of the game. So they had him corralled, and a good cutback by Alexander. He shows some good speed.
Terrific run.
A lot of patience there.
They kind of worked together a little bit. Here comes a little jab, a little move, a little jump cut. And now I'm going back, overrun. And
wow, good clear out block by Schnurr. And Alexander goes into the end zone. Three touchdowns. He's a wrecking ball on defense, and today he picks up three scores. And just like that, 49-21. Midland on top by 28 points. Their offense is clicking on all cylinders.
Dow cannot stop Midland. That's all there is to it. I mean, they just cannot. They've stopped them on one possession the whole game. Dow just cannot stop them. And again, it's not that you'll not be laying the fact, but Dow is beat up.
Right.
I mean, they've got some good players that are on that sideline. But that's no excuse. Midland is just clicking. I'm not sure if Dow had all of their players plus a few more. That's how good Midland is operating.
Well,
right,
the line
now
is a well-oiled machine right now, and they got the three backs. Plus, it's not just Williams doing the running.
Right. Well, I think Wilson and Alexander are running at a good pace. But here's the thing. I think this is the best blocking line that I've seen at Midland. And this includes the big boys.
Right.
I never thought they were great blockers. I thought they were big bodies. Mm-hmm. But I never thought they were great blockers. These guys get off the ball. There's a surge together. They are making a new line of scrimmage 3 yards deep in the Dow secondary.
Line drive kickoff. Hayes takes it at the 5. Good return by Mason Hayes. Late flag thrown. Colton on the tackle.
We're going to see another block, I think, behind. The runner.
It was a flag definitely behind the runner. And it's going to go against Dow because they're signaling to the coach the number of the player. Oh, it's personal foul, coach. It's not a hold. Must have been a late hit. And frustration setting in here, it looks like, because those are big yards. It's just going to take time to gain those yards back. Time not on Dow's side.
I don't believe I've ever seen Dow so chippy as I've seen him tonight. There have been a lot of plays that I've seen that there were not penalties called and should have been.
So here we go. Two receivers out to the left and to the right. Caleb Richard in the backfield. Cook in motion. He's going to keep it. And Miller is hit by McInerney at about the 26. About 6 yards on the pickup. as the clock continues to run. And then running different defenders in and out. Dow's offense definitely showing a lot more life this game than in the first meeting. But so is Midland's. A lot of points in this game. Richard takes the carry, and he is met. Michael Alexander again in the backfield. That guy is having a ball game. Three touchdowns rushing, and he's in on tackle after tackle.
Well, you got to design your offense that says, we are going to block Michael Alexander. We are going to block. And that's the emphasis you got to put on it all week long. You got to block the Midland linebackers. Sometimes you don't have to block the guys on the ground. There's only one guy down on the ground. You don't have to block him. Just spread him out and don't block him. I've yet to see Dow use wide splits.
Miller back to pass. He's under pressure. Hit from behind. This time, Azariah Porter on the tackle. Porter Koning on the tackle, and Miller had some room to run, and good closing speed by Porter Koning on that. Brings up fourth down. Dow really has to go for it here. What have you got to lose? Down by four scores. Fourth and about three. Maybe four. Richard in motion to the right. Miller back to pass. He's in trouble and brought down. The big sack by the Chemics. That's Brandon Delaney, the junior. And Miller just did not have time to let it go.
It's a three-man rush. And let's just take a look at where it happens.
Came from the outside. Good rush by a good defensive play by Delaney. And so Midland with the ball on about the 20. Just going with the big boys. And Wilson this time, big gain on first down. He's hauled down.
The Dow defense is tired right now. They're tired. They've had a lot of players that are going both ways. This is the 10th possession of the game for Midland. And that's a lot. Usually in a game you got 9 possessions, maybe 10. You're going to have maybe 12.
Where McLaughlin was on that tackle. But there's been a lot of quick drives, too,
right,
in this, so it's
right,
going to create
right,
more possessions. Double tight ends, just that power formation. Williams this time, and he's going to go into the end zone. What do you do? Just the holes are being blown open, and this time it's Williams for the touchdown. What an impressive performance by this Midland offense. See it again. Got the big hole. A good seal block by Fisher. And into the end zone goes Williams. It's just, guys, here it is. Try to stop it. And just great blocking, great running. Wonder's extra point is good. 56-21.
And we are now on the running clock.
Wow.
Twice.
Second time in 2 weeks.
Second time in history.
In history, that's true.
Second time in history.
Midland putting up 56 points.
I mean, you gotta kind of worry when, you know, in two games, you've given up almost 100 points. You know, and that's, and again, I take nothing away from Midland's offense. You know, Dow's defense is 101
points.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Just.
Said this is the second time these two teams have met in the postseason. Midland won the first one in 2005. This one for the district championship. So the winner of this game will be adding a trophy to their trophy case. And then next week we'll be taking on the winner of Lowell and Muskegon. Two traditional powerhouses.
Be an interesting rematch if Muskegon wins their game and Midland, you know, last year,
right.
If you remember, Muskegon put a running clock on Midland.
Yep, they did. High kick. Hayes takes it at 15. And good return, but he is hauled down by Diment. So you said it's a running clock. With 7 minutes to go. The very competitive first half, and then the second half. Well, Dow High's had a couple touchdowns and show good life, but Midland just able to move the ball so effectively. Caleb Richard on the carry.
Caleb Richard, the ball carrier.
He's brought down by Matt Nastasi.
Matt Nastasi on the stop.
Picked up about 7 on that play. Miller back to pass. No, he's going to keep it. Gets up the middle. Juts around, still on his feet. And he's going to get the first down. Try to cut it out to create a big play. He's able to move the chains. Miller, the senior, who said before, has to be considered one of the most improved players
absolutely
in the state of Michigan.
Absolutely, because he really did not play very well. He started as a sophomore,
was adequate. Last year he lost his job in the middle of the season and has come on this year and had been absolutely spectacular in my mind. He's an all-valley player and has made accurate throws just like that one right there and has been really the heart of the Dow offense.
Yep.
He picked up the spread offense faster than I ever expected it to happen. I thought, okay, you know, there are some other guys that may pick it up fast. But he picked it up fast, and his receivers have been spectacular. Now, the weakness is, you know, the depth of Dow. Dow does not have the depth to handle losing good players.
Miller.
Now, there's that jailbreak
Nally
screen.
Yep. That's a play that has had mixed results for Dow, but they run it very effectively, especially right there.
Now, the umpire almost got in the way again. I want you to watch this because he does a really good job of getting out of the way this time. Here's McNally coming in. Now, we're going to use the umpire as a blocker. Oh, see what I mean?
He got out of the way that time.
Little step there.
Could have used that
good move
in the first half.
Yeah.
Flag on the play.
Offside Midland.
Midland with
encroachment.
A lot of new guys out in the field now. And so, yeah, this offense definitely suited Miller this year, and it's one of those success stories where the guy just works on the offseason.
It really
and it
suited.
Pays off.
I mean, you know, even though these last two games against Midland have been disasters, you know, you got to give Dow a lot of credit. I mean, they're still 8 wins. You know, and that's a good year for anybody.
Miller hits Justin Cook. Cook is a, like said, is a sophomore. He's got a great future ahead of him for Dow as well. Very solid receiver. Ball down to the 25-yard line. Same play, this time to Rob, and he is hit and brought down by Belson. Try that same screen play. This time only get about a yard. A little over 3 minutes to play here on a cool, clear night at Midland Community Stadium. Good night for football. Richard looks down. He's got his man as McNally again. Still on his feet. Finally brought down. McNally having a huge game for Dow.
Well, I'll tell you.
McInerney on the stop.
One thing I'm going to say here, Dave, is that there's no quit in Dow.
No.
I mean, there's still. This game is over. There's no question about it, but they're still fighting out there to keep the game going. Got to be proud of them for that.
Yep, absolutely. Trips right. Miller, he throws in the end zone. Got him! Touchdown, Dow. And that is Mason Hayes for the score for the Chargers. Good patience by Miller, waiting that play out until he found his man in the back of the end zone.
See, everybody was worried about Caleb Richard. Now Miller breaks the play and then makes a throwback and right in the end zone. Nice catch.
Very nice.
Dow's receivers do catch the ball. They do catch the football.
So Kidd comes on for the extra point. And Kidd's kick is good. Kidd's extra point is good. 56-28. That's a lot of points. 94 points combined. The 56 points for Midland, the most ever scored in the 44-year rivalry. 46th game in this rivalry.
This is definitely the most points scored total.
And combined, absolutely.
I mean, we've had some 7-0 games that have been 7-6 games that have been spectacular.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, definitely this will break the record for combined points. Teams have top 40 several times. But first time any team has topped the 50 mark. So Dow will kick off back deep to receive 17, Bryce Kentek, and 24, TJ Cooper. Good boot caught by Kentek. At the two, good hard run by Kentek out past the 25-yard line.
Bryce Kentek on the return. Dimitri Stein on the stop.
So both teams now will get a lot of players to in the ball game here to experience playoff football.
Well, the clock is back on again, so it's not a running clock.
Ryan Lynch, who's the holder on the extra points and field goals, is the backup quarterback. 6, Derek Gruhl into the game. 95, Zach Schneider. And Cooper will take the handoff, drive ahead for about 5 yards.
Dimitri Stein on the stop.
Number 25, Andre Warren. He's just a freshman. He's a guy to watch, Coach, JV game.
I've watched him.
He put on a show.
Yeah, he is. He's a spectacular runner.
Takes the handoff. Drives ahead. Punishing run by the little guy. Peyton DeWilt, sophomore, in at quarterback now. There was a penalty on the play, a false start on Midland.
I tell you, I'm impressed. The officials have had a great game. It's, you know, it's a game that easily could have got out of hand. A lot of emotion, a lot of enthusiasm. And they've kept it under control and did a fabulous job. You know, you always like officials when you don't even think you need them.
Right.
You know, you didn't need them. And from the moment they took control of the chippiness, you really haven't noticed them.
Warren still on his feet, drives ahead. You're going to notice Warren runs very similar fashion to Williams.
Exactly. That's exactly what I was thinking. I'm saying, all right, he got into the seam, got a little run, broke a tackle right here. And that's a varsity player right there, number three. And number one is a varsity player. I mean, varsity starter, one of them, an All-Valley guy, and he broke the tackle.
Lynch back in at quarterback. Ooh, high snap. Lynch is going to keep it. A little stiff arm. Drives ahead. Good run by Lynch.
Brian Lynch, blocker.
Coach Mettner getting a lot of players into the game now. With 30 seconds remaining, this should be the last snap of the game. It's time to Wilt at quarterback. Warren's going to be hauled down. And that is going to do it. And so the Midland Chemics are your district champions with a very impressive performance, defeating crosstown rival Dow 56-28. Dow, no need to hang your heads. A great season for the Chargers, 8-3 on the year. And their season will end at the 8-3 mark. Midland moves on. They are 10-1 now. They will move on to face the winner of Lowell and Muskegon. And so we will be right back after this quick message. And we're back as the two teams shake hands. A lot of respect. This is a heated rivalry that much anticipation, especially for this playoff game, but a lot of respect from a lot of guys who have been playing sports throughout the years, back and forth against each other and with each other. And so as they shake hands, we'll take a look at our second half highlights here. And there were a lot of them in the second half as well. That third quarter, very explosive quarter, starting with this play on the
right
opening kickoff.
Bat.
Identical
ball
to the start
hits.
Of the game, just switching the teams.
Looked like my wedge shot. Took a little bite. Touchdown right off the bat to ear.
They ran that
wide
full house
open.
Backfield, yep. And just leaked ear out.
And then here's an excellent run here by Caleb Richard. And a good save. And here's a terrific pass right down the sideline that DeLong makes a great play to save the touchdown. And this is a 4th and 12, and Cook catches the football in that seam. And then this is Will running the pitch.
The next play.
And right off the bat, right back in the ballgame, but Dow did a squib kick. And then, you know, just Will Williams is just spectacular tonight. But these guys here, Wilson and Alexander really did quite a job. This is a long pass here to Travis McNally right off the bat. You know, trading touchdown for touchdown. Now, you can't. It looks good, but you can't trade touchdown for touchdown.
The next, very next
yeah,
play.
Yeah, here comes, and we're going to trade another touchdown here. And Will Williams runs into the end zone, and there's no catching him. He does know where the end zone
he
is.
He sure does.
And he does know where the hole is. A nice catch by Mike Robb down on the sideline and fighting for a few more yards. And then this is, again, Will Williams making a break and a touchdown-saving shoot top tackle. And look out, here's Michael Alexander. And I think you described it best. He is a beast. He is tough. He makes big plays. And this is just a break by Will Williams again. He just got better as the night went on.
Yep.
This is one of the few jailbreak screens that really were efficient for Dow. And here is, again, this is, I think, a touchdown pass. Passed down in the corner to McNally.
McNally had a big game for Dow.
And this is the touchdown pass right here.
To Mason Hayes.
And then good run here at the end of the game.
That's a sign of the future there for Midland. Under Warren. And so we will wrap things up. The trophy presentation on the field. Dow High present very respectfully as the trophy will be handed off to head coach Eric Mettner. Eric Albright, athletic director of Midland High, hands off the trophy, and the jubilant Chemics gather up in celebration, and they will move on in the playoffs. And as we mentioned, they will take on Lowell or Muskegon.
Muskegon won.
Muskegon won, so it will be Muskegon, rematch from the playoffs from last year. And so as we see the Chemics celebrate on the field, the blue helmets held high in celebration, we will wrap things up here. Again, this is Dave Marsh and the old ball coach Frank Altimore. Happy to bring you the action this season. It's been a pleasure, coach, once again.
Always great, Dave.
Great season. And we'll sign off by saying good luck, Chemics, and the rest of the playoffs. Good night, everybody.